In this video, we're going to review bringing a ASCII file into LP360 and converting it into a shapefile. The situation that pertains to us bringing this in would be we had a control file for a site that has checkpoints in it, and we're going to be using that for our control point dialog. So we want to bring in those checkpoints and compare them to our point cloud. We've got to convert them to the proper format first. So to do that, go to File, Import from ASCII XYZ. Choose our output format. We'll choose shapefiles. We're creating a shapefile out of that ASCII file. Choose Add. I'm going to navigate to that text file or the ASCII file. Click Open. So you can see it loaded in just fine. I can see the labels of my points and the eastings, northings, elevation, and the type of control points or checkpoints that I'm bringing in. You're going to want to choose this selected folder to write to. It's automatically going to drive you to the folder that the ASCII file came from. If you wanted to make a new folder or choose a different location, you could do that here. Normally, I just put it in the same folder that the ASCII file came from. You can click OK here if you want to do that. Now we're going to click Next. This is comma delimited format, so I'm going to choose that option. Next. We're going to choose the comma format. You can see here it's separated all the attributes up nice and neatly here. Click Next. Now we have to define the shapefile attributes that we're bringing in. So the first column is going to be name. Depending on how you collect your control, your northing or easting could be in the next column here. So just make sure you pick the one that corresponds to the formatting that you chose to do previously. For our project here, it's going to be easting, northing, and elevation. And for the last column, this is very important, I'm going to choose type. And this is the control point or checkpoint method that we use for identifying those checkpoints in the control point report dialog. You can also do SRS conversions here. For example, if I would have output my LAS or point cloud data and my ortho or raster data into a specific coordinate reference system SRS, and it was in a different SRS than my original control file, then I could do the conversion here. All I need to know is the initial coordinate reference system that my control file is in. Once I know that, I can convert to any other one here in the target. So it could be an issue of units. Maybe you wanted to use different units. You can do that conversion here. So let's go ahead and click on Finish. I already have some. I've already done this previously. It's just asking, do I want to replace them? I'm going to click Yes. Import's complete. You can see here that it automatically added that layer into my table of contents. I can see my control points. I can zoom in on the little yellow dots. Those are my control points and my checkpoints. If for whatever reason they didn't add properly, click on your Add LAS Raster Feature Layer button here at the top. Click on Add Feature. And you can see it, just like the import from ASCII, it's going to automatically navigate to that folder where we put the shapefile. So it's just going to automatically go there without you having to navigate to it. As long as you do this right after you do your import from ASCII. So we could choose it here for whatever reason, didn't show up in our table of contents after that first, when we first created the shapefile. So it's just that easy to create a shapefile from an ASCII format. Let's go to, we'll right click on this, go to Feature Analyst, and you can see how those points have been defined.